Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video, which is going to be, can you guess what it's going to be? Can you guess? This is all lipsticks, all in one basket, and then here are all my glosses, liquid lipsticks, lip balms, and such, and I am going to go through them today. Yes, and my eyeshadow palette declutter collection thingamajingy is coming as well. So make sure you are subscribed and have hit the bell. Yes, you know the drill, right? What I'm going to do now is I kind of want to group it by, I want to say species. So that's what we're going to do. I already have my lipsticks in one basket. What I'm also going to do here is grab my liquid lipsticks and glosses. And in the glosses I will also put lip balms and all that.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
So let's start with the liquid lipsticks. So let's start with these two, which are from VE Cosmetics. These are liquid moisture. Oh, there we are. These are liquid moisture lipsticks. So basically the brownie one does not really dry down. And the black one dries down a bit. But they're not as dry as liquid lipsticks. So they're very nice and comfortable. I really like these. So these are staying. Then I have these from VE Cosmetics. The shade Damon I have swatched, which is a very, very dark red. I don't really know if I like it. I don't go for a shade like that often. This is the shade Rune, which I do like. And then I have the shade Anarchy, which is a gray. And I don't have a lot of grays. So Anarchy and Rune are staying. This one is also, this one I got in PR, which is the shade Arachna. And it is a metallic liquid lip. And I don't use it often, but I do like it, a metallic lip. I think it's fun. So that one is staying too. This one is going in the, yeah, I'm going to reserve this one for now. Yes. Let's go to, do I have, yeah, Odin's Eye I have here as well. I only have two from Odin's Eye, which are the shade Perfect Plum and Ripe Papaya. So here is Ripe Papaya, which is a little bit of a burnt orange. And here is other shade. I don't use them a lot, but I do want to keep them. I have three from Black Moon Cosmetics. These, they are not going anywhere. I have the shade Grim, Cider and Hazel. All three colors are staying. Let's go to Carity because I have a green one of that as well. Where's my other one? I have two. Where is it? Oh, here. So these are the two that I have from Carity, and this is Matcha Gracias. I think I'm going to, it's going in the maybe pile. I don't know yet. And then this is the shade Whatever, which is one of my favorite shades. It is a cool toned one, but yeah, I don't know. Even though I am an olive, it's a pretty color. I don't know. It just does something on my lips. I like it. It's staying. Let's go to some from X Revolution. I think that's everything. Okay. This one is going, it's not my color at all, which is the shade Nostalgia. It's way too cool for me. This one is going as well, which is the shade Brainwash. If I want a hot pink, this is not the one I grab. And then this one is a very deep purple in the shade Frank. I think I am going to keep this one because I like the formula enough and the color is unique enough that I'm going to keep it. And then here I have, what have I, a Sequel and Ticket. I think I would like this one a little bit more, which is an, I don't use liquid lipsticks a lot anymore though. Yeah, I'm going to keep Tickle and I'm going to get rid of Sequel. Let's go to Ofra. I think that's everything that I have left because I don't have a lot left anymore. These were gifts with purchase. This is the shade Ball Harbor and the shade Mina. I'm going to get rid of Mina because I don't use that. And the shade Ball Harbor, let's see. It's actually almost the same as this one, right? But this is a mini. I'm going to get rid of it. I haven't used it a lot. This is Miami Fever. Okay, and then here I have Verona. I kind of like these shades. I don't use them though. They are going in the maybe pile. I don't know yet. So, yeah, okay. Let's next go to Janelica. This was PR. This is in the shade Disco. It was not a bad formula at all. I like this formula. Oh yeah, this is one that is a little bit... It is almost like a vinyl. It kind of wants to dry down, but it does not really. I think I'm going to... I'm going to keep it. I don't have a lot of pinks. Okay, let's next go to Kaleidos. I have both sets here. They are not going anywhere. They are staying. I like this formula a lot. Yes, so they are all staying. Okay, let's go to these. No, these are the two that I have from iHeart Revolution. They are actually not bad. They are not a bad formula. And they look like metallics. They are not though. So this is a forested green. And it goes on metallic, but it dries down matte. I have a teal in the Kaleidos. Let's see what that one does. I think I'm going to let these two go. Because I have not used them. And every time I'm looking at them, I'm like, yeah, but I will use them. Maybe I can use them for a look, but I'm not going to. So they're going to go away. They're not bad, though. Okay, I also have a bunch from AOS Studios. So these are the ones from AOS Studio. This is actually, I thought it was a black, but it is a... It's not a black. It's a very dark gray metallic. It was a very interesting shade. This one is staying because it's unique for me. This one... No, that one's going. Oh, I also have lippies from Liora. I almost forgot. This is a very, very orange one. Now, the formula from... That one's going. This is way too hot orange for me. The formula on these is not bad. They are a little bit drying, but again, with some... nourishing lip mask underneath, it is okay. What am I going to do with this one? It is a unique purple. I don't have a lot of purple, so that one is staying. This is, what was this again? I kind of like metallics. This is a bit more of a corally one. I think I'm going to keep this just because it's nice and summery. And with gloss on top, I can kind of tone it down a bit. So that one is staying. That was the color Insta. Yes, and then, I'm so sorry. This is the color Naughty. It's a very unique. It's kind of a, it is a red, but also kind of like a pink. I don't think I ever wore this, but I am keeping this for now. These are the two that I bought from Lethal Cosmetics. And honestly, the shades, I don't know, it's kind of... I went by shade description and the shade description was a bit wonky. But okay, this is the shade Anema. And it's kind of like this one, the one that I decluttered. But yeah, so they are very, very new though. This is the one I'm wearing right now, which is Departure. You cannot see that, but I'm wearing Departure. But then with a gloss on top to make it a bit more peachy. The formula is very nice though. So yeah, they are new, so both are staying. Okay, let's go to Makeup Revolution. Oh yeah, I also have another one from iHeart Revolution. A purpley sparkly one. Let's see. Yeah, I think I use this as kind of a topper shade. It's staying, because I think it's fun. Yes, that is everything from the liquid lipstick line from Makeup Revolution. So let's start with this one, which is the shade Hustle, I think. No, TGIF. Wow, I cannot read. The letters are too tiny. Which is a very dark brown. I do prefer this one though. Because I feel like the TGIF shade that I have here. Oh, it's also kind of leaking, which is very annoying. But it is also a little bit, almost a little bit too red for what I go for. So I'm going to declutter it. I don't wear that one a lot, or ever actually. Then I have here the shade Darling. The formula on these is very nice though. This is a very, very pale, kind of a peachier one, but I think I need to shake these up again. That one is staying. Okay, then I have here the shade Head Turner, which was one of my favorites. This is a little bit more of an an orangey one. They are quite close though, aren't they? Maybe I like this one a little bit better. So let's, I do think I use this one more. Let's put it next to it. And then here I have the shade Hustle. Hustle I wear a lot when I have a blue eye look. So that one is staying. I think I'm going to get rid of Darling, which is this one. And I'm going to keep a Head Turner for another round. Yes, and I also have some of their matte creams. So let me get those. Yes, that's it. Okay, I have Muse. What was it with Muse again? Oh yeah, that's also a very nice shade. And then Vow Head Turner in this one. Yeah, I like Head Turner in the cream more than I like it in the liquid. So that one is staying. It's a little bit more sheer. This one is staying, the darker one, and that one's going. Yes, I'm going to clean my arm.
298 frozen patties later.
Okay, let's go. Arm is clean-ish and moisturized and such. I'm going to go. This one is old. This is from Gerard Cosmetics in the shade. What is it? Knight Rider, and it bleeds, so it's going. Let's go to. Okay, this one from MUA. I really love the color, but it's old in the shade Poise, so it's going. I have here Dose of Colors Sand. I don't wear this one. I did like this one though, but I think I have an equivalent in a lipstick. It's a maybe. Let's go here to these. Let's see. This is the shade Muddy Madness. It is just such a friendly brown shade. It is an older one. It still smells okay, so it's staying. Then my other favorite of the line is this one in the shade Move to the Rhythm. Where is it? Here it is. Llama Poo, which I usually use in winter. Yeah, it's staying, and the formula is really nice. Move to the Rhythm. Let's see. Am I finally getting rid of this one? This is the shade. Am I Unique, or I Am Unique, from their newest matte line? The trouble is, I don't wear shades like this a lot. And this is Trust in Me. And here I have Newtown Express from their old line. I thought I had something similar. Didn't I? This one is staying. This one's going. Move to the Rhythm is going. This one, I don't know. I don't know yet. Okay. My favorite red is this one. Exotic Rebel. Still smells good. This is not going anywhere. It has a little bit of a metallicness in it, which I really, really like. Then I have a Pillow Fight. I like this one a little bit more, actually. But I... you know, I have a lot of trouble with pinks right now. This one is a little bit more peachy. So this one is going. And this one, which is this one, is the shade Braveness Wins. That one can stay because it's a little bit more towards the orangey side. This is My Life, My Decision, or something like that. My Destiny, I don't know. This range is very pink leaning. No, that one's going. This is the shade Courage Code, yeah. It's pretty. She can stay for another round. And I think I'm getting rid of this one. I don't use it. Here I have two from Madage Beauty London that I got in PR. Formula is okay. It's not my most favorite formula, but the formula is okay. I actually like the pinky one. I don't mind it too much. And there is a hint of a sparkle in it. So I think I'm going to declutter this one because I... Oh, maybe Maybe I'll keep them. I'm going to keep the pinky one because I kind of like that it has a sparkle in it. And I kind of like that this one has a sparkle in it as well. And this one is getting a little bit old, so I'm going to see if I'm going to use this one instead of the other one. Then I have here one from Be Your Own Desire that I got in PR. I can make it work, but as you can see, it really stands out. So I'm going to pass this one along. It's a very nice formula though. And then here I have one of the creams in the shade Violet. This one was pretty. I think I'm going to keep this one for just another round. Okay, I have NYX here. It says everything that I have from NYX, I think so. So this is a lip cream in London. I'm not really a big fan of this formula, honestly. I think I'm going to declutter this one because I don't know. It's a little bit too drying. And then I have here the new lingeries. I have two shades. I like them. So this shade I really like, which is the shade Turn On. I think it's a very pretty shade. And then the other one I have is a corally one in Peach Flirt. Oh, peach. Oh. Yeah, I'm going to keep both. Okay, this one you cannot get anymore from Miu Miu. It's a matte. It is what it says. A liquid lip matte. Yeah, it's not my favorite formula. Oh yeah, here. The shade Leo from Menagerie Cosmetics. Do you hear this? There's a weight in here. And the weight is loose. I already had to glue it back once. But that's okay. It's not my favorite formula at all, but it's a very unique color. And that is the reason that it is staying, just because of, only because of the color. Because the formula is quite drying, I find at least. But the color is very, very unique. So that is why I am keeping it. And then I have two of, what is it, Catrice Ultimate Stay lip tints. These are actually very nice. So I have the shade... I don't know. It's a peachy one and it's a redder one. So this one, it's very, very close to my lips. So it does not really do a lot for me. It's pretty though. And then here is the other one. So they are fun. So this one does not do a lot, which I kind of find a shame because I like this color the best. So I'm getting rid of this one and I'm keeping this one because this is basically you ate a popsicle. You know, that's the gist of it. Can I see the color? The color is... Oh, Loyal to Your Lips. That's the color that is staying. And the color that is going, it's just too close to my own skin tone, is Stay On Over. Okay, liquid lipstick wise, what am I going to do with these? I'm going to get rid of those of color sand. The one from Carity. Sure. This one, shade Damon. This one is going because it has that dark redness and I don't really like that. It does something wonky on me. Verona and Miami Fever from Ofra. I actually think I'm going to pass them along. And the reason is that the colors are not really unique in my collection. And I detest the fact that, can you see that? I detest the fact that the component is broken. I don't mind the formula at all. It's just that I have this. So I'm going to pass those along. Okay, let's go to my glosses. This is new from Colourpop. I have more from Colourpop. Where's the other one from Colourpop? Oh, yeah. So here is a lip gloss. So lip glosses, lip oils, they're kind of in the same basket. So here I have a Luxe Gloss in the shade Orchid. And I have the lip oil in the shade Hot Spark. I really like these. The lip oils, and I've mentioned this before, I don't know if you have seen the video, but for me they feel like a combination between the 5-in-1 lip balms from Catrice, the liquid lip balms that I have as well, and their lip oils. So they are for me a little bit in between. This one has a lot of substance in it without being gloopy. I really like it, but I also like the gloss. So yeah, both are staying because they are new. Let's push it down. Yes, these are also staying. These are PR from DJ's Unique Boutique. Fun fact is that when I got these, there's another color, a blue one, that I opted out of because I wasn't going to wear it. I thought I would use this one the most because it's a neutral color, but I actually use these two the most. Especially if I'm doing a purple eye look that has also a little bit of blue. This is just so, so pretty to put on top of a lipstick or whatever. And this one, this rose gold, yeah, it's very, very flattering on an olive complexion. So all three are staying and the formula is very, very nice. Let's go to my favorite gloss of the moment. Formula-wise. And that's these from Lethal Cosmetics. This is the one that I've been raving about. The shade Nova. This is just... I need to be in frame. This is just such a pretty color. When I swatch it, it does not really... I don't know. It doesn't look that exciting. But when I put it on my lips, or when I put this on top of a lipstick or a liquid lipstick, because I don't know how they did it with their formula, they are amazing to layer. This is just so stunning. And I have a lipstick from them in the shade Quest, which is too hot, bright orange for me. And then this is the one that I tone it down with. And it's just stunning. So definitely staying. The formula is very much worth it. Then the next one that I got, which is new, is the shade Everything. And this one I have on today, because I actually peached up a pink liquid lipstick. So this is just your, you know, your almost your old school funky, hunky, glossy thingamajig. Whatever, never mind, don't judge. Yes, I also have one of the... Those are staying. The Flexi Slicks from Ofra. I think I wore these twice. I do like the color. Maybe I need to try this one, because I have not... Here it is. I really do like the color, but I haven't worn it in so long. I kind of forgot about it. So I am going to try this one again. Yes. The Elf Retro Paradise. This is just... Where are we? This is just one of those glosses that you can just chuck in your bag and chuck on just to make sure that you have, I don't know, a sparkly gloss and such. So it's very, very nice for that. And that's actually what I use it for. I haven't used it a ton since, but I do like it with the sparkly goodness. So it is staying. Then I have a plumping gloss from Essence. This is the What the Fake lip gloss. It looks white, but it is not really. This has a minty. So if you like minty, This is one, and it's just a clear minty gloss. Usually this is Downstairs. It's a nice gloss. It's not very gloopy. It's one that's a little bit more sticky, which I like. So yeah, it's staying. No, this is not a... Do I still have it? Or did I already toss it? Oh no. I'm finally getting rid of this one. The butter gloss in Cookie Butter. This was my favorite gloss for so long. It's so old. I don't know. I think I just need to get rid of this. Yes. Yes, I use this. These types of very sticky, gloopy glosses I use when I go outside in winter and I go running, for instance. So that's when I use stuff like this. But this one is so old. I haven't touched it in ages because I don't know. I felt like it was kind of going bad. So I'm going to actually toss it. Then I have here another butter gloss in the shade Madeline. What was it with this? Why is it still upstairs? I think this one is still okay. This one needs to go downstairs. Yeah, so this one I am going to keep for now. Okay. Oh, let's go to this one. This is a very old one. Well, not really. This is from Primark. The gloss formula kind of reminds me a little bit of the... It's a very sticky one. I thought I also had another color. Honestly, I kind of forgot about this one. It's going in a maybe. I thought I was getting rid of this, but it's going to go in a maybe. Let's grab one that is going to stay, which is a mini from Rare Beauty in the shade, I think it's Natural. Oh, Nearly Neutral. It's nice. It's, again, kind of a combination. I think they're calling it a lip balm, but it is a little bit, yeah, liquid lip balm with a hint of a color. Yeah, that's kind of what it is. It's nice, lightly tinted, but it is staying. It's new. It's staying. These are my liquid lip balms from Catrice that I still need to do a video with that I haven't done and I probably won't ever do, knowing me, knowing you. The formula on these is very, very nice. Ah, here's the other one. The formula of these is very, very nice. These are liquid lip balms and honestly, if you like the colors and you like something that's a little bit more sheer, let's go with this one. So I can kind of show you. So this is it. So it is still sheer, but it does have a little bit of a tint. So yeah, I do have my favorites. So this one is my favorite, which is Pearly Peach. I thought I liked this one as well, Golden Ginger.
Yeah, that one I like as well, so that one's staying. Luminous Grapes was the first one that I got. And I think I'm keeping this one. And let's see the names. Glossy Apricots, Raspberry... Raspberry cream, what happened? I don't know. Lychee glaze. I also had to use lychee glaze. Raspberry cream. Honestly, they're all they are all nice. Why is it so difficult?
You know what? I'm just going to keep them all because why not? I am. Because I can. So don't judge. I have room. Oh, this should not be in here. This is a Matte Pro ink. But it's a very, very hot red. Yes, it's going because it's too thingamajingy. This one, my Nabla Viper, is staying because I love it to death. And then here I have two lip oils from Catrice. This is the shade Cherry Blossom Glow. And I have the shade Raspberry Glow. So I have two. These I use a crap ton. Can you see how much I've used this one? A lot of the time when you guys ask me what is on your lips, it's this one. And it's very, very nice. So it is staying. These are two of their normal glosses. This is in the shade Shimmery Goldstone, if I'm not mistaken. Very nice as well. But it's almost the same as my Nova. And then here I have Glowing Tourmaline. They are kind of like the ones that I have now from Lethal. And the ones from Lethal are better to layer on top of lipsticks. So I'm going to get rid of these. And I'm going to, well, keep the one from Lethal. Because they are almost the same. It's just a formula thing. Then I have, do I have two? Yeah, two Sheer Brilliant glosses from Makeup Revolution. I kind of liked them. But I am going to get rid of them because I have not used them in ages. This one from Creepy Cosmetics, Hocus Pocus, was PR. I have another one, I think downstairs, which is a clear one. Yeah, these are just very, very handy dandy to chuck in your bag. But one is enough for me, so I think I'm going to give this one to my niece because she will like it. Okay, then this is my favorite I Heart Revolution gloss. This is in the shade Honeycomb. This ain't going anywhere. I also have this one from Charlotte Tilbury. This was a gift. And it's also a plumping gloss. I think that the applicator is weird though. It's a nice formula. The color is also nice. I like the plumping, plumpingness of it. I think the color is pretty. So I am going to keep it. What do I have here? We have some vinyl cherries here as well. I am going to get rid of them all. Because I just... They are nice, but they are not what I use. This is the shade Salted Caramel and Mint Chocolate. Let's see color-wise. I am going to get rid of this one because it's just a little bit too cool tone. It turns a little bit purple on me. And this is Mint Chocolate. Yes, and then this one is Salted Caramel is staying. And then that is it for the glosses. This one, where did I put it there? I'm going to get rid of this because it's in the shade Tease because I have not used it in ages. So I'm just going to get rid of it. Let me clean the arm.
1 minute, 37 seconds later.
Okay, dokie. Then the last thing is lipsticks. It's not nearly as many. Yes, okay, so let's start with these two, which are technically, yeah, lipstick, lip balms. These were PR, Evening Glory and Robin Rose from Chrome Pebble. Yeah, the colors are not really... Although this one and then Sheared Out I do like, and that's Robin Rose, so I'm keeping Robin Rose, and I am decluttering... that one. These are all staying as well. These are from Propa Beauty. I have the shade Profits. I have the shade Limitless. And I have the shade Made It. Those are staying. These two are also staying, which are from Lethal Cosmetics. This is the shade Sand Nudes. And here I have the shade Quest. And this is the shade Quest that I use with the shade Nova. So the color is gorgeous. It's just that when I use it, it's almost too... I almost want to say too neon for me, so it does. It looks a little bit weird, but when I then put the shade Nova on top, it's perfect for me. It's a very, very pretty color then. Do I have the shade Nova? Where is it? Because I can show you. So it just turns a very, very pretty... For me, a very pretty peach. It tones it down a bit. And I'm actually curious to see what it will do with this one. Yeah, that one makes it a little bit more brighter, but a little bit lighter. And then on this one on top of that, oh yeah, that's pretty. Yeah, that's pretty. So yeah, Nova for Quest and then everything for the Scent Nudes. Was that Scent Nudes? These from Essence, the Instacare. I think I'm going to toss these because these are pretty old. They are very, very nice though. They feel like a lip balm, but they are color. It still smells okay though, this one. They're very, very comfortable. This one is not my color. This one turns purple on me. See? So this one is going... I'm just going to toss this one. This one is going to go away. And this one... Maybe. Maybe. Then I have... let's see. Is this all Catrice? Yes, this is all Catrice, right? Yeah. So I have three Mad Lover lipstick pens. I have the shade... Unexpected Mauve. Yeah, the formula is very nice, but it's not my color, so it's going to go. Then I have the shade In the Mood for Nude. Yeah. And I have Top It with Cinnamon. I love this, but it turns very... It's not really flattering on me. So that one is going to go too. Yeah, they are all... Let's put you there. They are all going to go. Because I just... It's just not my color. So yeah. Okay, I have these two from NYX. That's everything that I have from NYX, right? Yeah, and then this one. Okay, so these are two turned up lipsticks. And I really do like these. This is the shade... Stone, and I think I used this one the most. But I also had one that was a little bit warmer. I don't remember where I left that one. Stone, is it here? Is this Stone? Yeah, that's also Stone. Huh. I think I got rid of that one then. I think. Or is it somewhere? I don't know. If I still have it, I will find it. And this is the shade Flutter Kiss. This is a pinky nude. It's better than that one. I like the format. If I want a pinky nude, this is probably one that I'm going to keep this one in the maybe pile. And then this one. These two are going to go. These two are in the maybe pile. I don't know yet. Yes. This one is from Kiko in the shade. I don't know. 04. It's a Hydra Stylo. It's a very, very comfortable formula. She like this color a little bit more than the one from NYX. So I'm going to get rid of Flutter Kiss. And this one is then going in the maybe pile. I have one from NYX as well, which is the Dazed and Diffused. This is a lip pencil that you can fade out. If I want a hot pink, this is the one I grab. So this is staying. Where is my staying? There. Then I have... let's go to these from Sof. Yeah, these. These are lip balms, and I actually thought that they were lipsticks, but they are lip balms. So here I have the brownie. It does not really do a lot. And here I have the pinky. Yeah. On top of a lip liner, they are nice. But I'm just not going to use these, so I'm going to see if my niece will like these. Okay, then I have Colourpop bunch. I like Colourpop lipsticks. Okay, so let's put it to the side. So I have two of their black line. I have the shade Pitch and I have the shade Like Magic. And all my lipsticks are staying. The shade Pitch is the dark brown that I was looking for in a lipstick format without it turning any other color than brown on me. The only thing I want to bitch about is that this sticker I put on it myself because I had to remove it from the box because the name wasn't on the bottom. So that's the only thing I want to bitch about. Let's go to the first one that I ever bought, which was the shade Cookie, which is just such a favorite shade of mine. It's just so, so pretty. It's very, very flattering on me. This is a lipstick in the shade Fab. I need to make sure I'm in frame. I keep forgetting. I like this color a lot as well. It's very, very pretty. And then I have, what's this? Unreal. And then I have the shade Good Times, which is a little bit more, well, almost a neutrally darker brown, but still very, very nice. So can you see what I'm gravitating towards right now? This purpley, I can see it turning, yeah, not really flattering, right? But yeah, what can you do? I have also a bunch from Catrice. Is that everything that I had from Catrice? Really? I thought I had more. Oh no, I tossed that one because it stank. So I have here two from their Clean ID line. I have Mocha Delight and Nude Blush. These are very nice. Oh yeah, and this is like the one from Soft but Prettier and I have more substance. And then here was Mocha Delight and I think this one was my favorite. It's just very, very pretty. But this one also, they're just very pretty. They say that this is a satin formula. I don't know. I think they're nice and shiny. Both are staying. I like the formula a lot. Then I have an Essence Perfect Shine lipstick in the shade 4. Yeah, it's going to go. It survived the last declutter, but I'm not going to use it, so it's going to go. And then I have one from Asgard Queen Cosmetics that I got in PR. Now, I really do like the shade, but it's a formula thing. I really like the shade, though. I think I'm going to keep it. Yes. Okay, then I have Glam Shop Poland. Do I only have two? I thought I had more. Really? Huh. Well, apparently I have two. Okay, I have the shade Biscop Tova. Which is a very, very pale. But it is a very, very pale peachy nude. It's very pretty. It's one of my favorites. So it's staying. And I have the shade Mirabelka. And this one is a little bit more pink. So I actually prefer this one. But I do really like this one. Yeah, and this one, the one from NYX, is going to go as well. Because it's annoying me. I'm keeping both shades. So yeah, I have one that's a little bit more orangey. And I have one that's a little bit more peachy pinky. I like both. Yeah. Then I have, oh yeah, my salt and pepper. This is not going anywhere. This was not really bought to use. It's just for me more of a collector's item. The color is nice though. The formula is nice. But it was their salt and pepper collab. So yeah, it's staying. And then I have Madage Beauty London. I also have two lipsticks that I got in PR. This is the shade Carnation, I think. Which is a very, very hot. It's a very hot pink, but it has a sparkly in it. Now, this is not something that I use often. And the other shade is Tsubaki. I actually like this one better. So I'm going to give this one away. Tsubaki. Yes. And I'm going to keep Carnation, the hot pink. Just because I don't have a lot of those shades. And sometimes I want something like this. You know? Yes. Then let's go to this one, which is from I Heart Revolution. It is the lipstick in Honeycomb. Now, when you see it, you're like, bitch, that's way too cool toned for you. Yeah, it is. And when I swatch it on my hand, it turns gray. But when I put it on my lips, it's just, there's just something about this that makes it very, very flattering. Or at least I think so. It's a very unique color in my collection, so I'm keeping it. It's almost the same shade as Amber from Fenty for contouring. Then I have a shade from a lipstick from Max & More in the shade Creme Brulee. Max & More is a very cheap Dutch brand sold at Action. The lipstick is very nice though. And it's also very pretty. See? It's a very pretty formula. It's a very pretty color on me as well. Do I have an alternative? Yeah, kind of do. It's right smack in between these two colors, isn't it? It's very pretty. I actually never wear it because I cannot link it. I am going to keep it because it's my only Max & More lipstick though. So if I want to do a full face or an almost full face of Max & More, I can, you know. And then I have one lipstick from Flower Beauty in the shade Bare Pout. I won this in a giveaway once. This is a very, very pale pink. And now I am just going to get rid of it because it's just, it's not that it is too light, because it's not, but it's just the pinkness in combination with the light. Yeah, it's not my color at all. And then I have here a newer one in my collection as well from Kiko. It's a Smart Fusion lipstick in the shade 456. This one was a present, so it's not going. but there it is. Okay, so that's staying. Then I have two from Neve. These were also presents. And these are more along the lines of lip balms as well. They are minis. And they're so cute. So this is the shade Spice Up. So it's a very pretty, can I put it here? Very pretty wash of, I don't know if you can see it, but I can see it in real life. It's an orangey wash. And then here I have the shade Silky Glow, which for me, it does not really, it doesn't do anything, honestly. This one I do use, this one I actually don't really use. I'm keeping it because they were a gift and I just loved it so much. But yeah, on me, it doesn't, on my lips also, it just doesn't do anything because it's too close to my lips. So yes, it's very nice to have just as a lip balm or something like that. So these are both staying. And then I have my Juvia's Place left. Come here. My Juvia's Place, let's see. I have the shade Lady. Let's put you here. Lady, which is one of my favorites. Very pretty. Then we have the shade, what do I usually pair it with? Muted, that's what I compare it to. Which is more of a cool tone. Don't use it a lot anymore, but it is staying. Then I have Libra. Invoke. And Toffee. I'm going to hang on to all of them for now. Okay, let's go to, what did I say again, the Kiko one. That was this one, right? Yeah, I don't use it a lot, but I kind of do like it, so it can stay. This one from Essence, while I really, really like it, I think I'm just going to toss this because it's old, like me. So yeah, and that was it. Let me clean my arms and then count everything because I'm very, very curious what I kept and what I'm going to give away. The tally is in. Yes. So I had quite a lot of lipsticks. I had 155 in total. Yes. The lipsticks, I am keeping 30. I'm decluttering 13. And the glosses, I am keeping 25 and I'm decluttering 12. And I have to kind of give you a little bit of extra information. This one, the Flexi Slick from Ova, I was like, let me try it. Then I remembered why I've never worn it, because I detest the formula. So that one is going to go as well. So, and it's already calculated in the tally. So yeah, 25 glosses and lip oils and balms are staying. 12 are going. And then from the liquid lips, I actually wanted to kind of round it out a little bit as well. So what I did for the liquid lipsticks, I pulled this one from Dose of Colors. I tried it. It's gritty. So I'm going to toss this one as well. And then this one from X Revolution. Honestly, I am keeping the dark purple because it's the only dark purple that I have. But honestly, this is just, it's a shade that I won't use this. Yeah, and that's it. And then the total for my liquid lipsticks is that I am keeping is 45 then. Yes, 45. And I'm decluttering 30. So in total, I am keeping 100 lippies and getting rid of 55, which is still a lot. It is still a lot. And honestly, could I tone it down? Could I pull more? Probably. Let me put everything back and go through everything again, especially the liquid lipsticks. And if I decide to pull, I will let you know. Yes. Okay, the total tally. I pulled one other lip gloss, this one. It's just, I can keep it, but I know that I won't use it. Yeah, it's a nice gloss, but I have more nice glosses. So yeah, that's the one from e.l.f. And then I also pulled these liquid lipsticks because honestly, I know I won't use them, so I pulled those as well. So the final tally is I am keeping 93, which are already in their containers again, and I am decluttering 62, which is a substantial amount now, isn't it? So yeah, and this is what is going to go away. I am happy about that. I have some more room, and yeah, this was it for today. Let me know if you had any of these. Let me know if it was entertaining. And then thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye.